Hi there, my name is Kendall Johnson. I'm a film, TV, and video game composer. The main thing that you can do with this library that you can't do, I found with other libraries, is really have your own sound. You know, all other libraries kind of have their distinct string tone, articulations, and you're kind of always bound to that, you know. With this one, you have the ability to control dynamics, you have the ability to do different bowing techniques, you have the ability to do different, make string players, force them to play on the second, third, and fourth string. And any combination of all those with the control of dynamics and attack and then gliss and time spread and pitch and all these different abilities give you that passionate ability to make your own style, make your own legato yours and custom. So, you know, which is really important when you're, you know, making projects that especially might not be going to an actual live orchestra. They might just be using your strings. At first, you're going to look at the interface, and it's going to be kind of, you know, daunting. You're going to be kind of blown away with all that you can control. You know, you can, all the buttons to control tremolando, pizzicato, barto pits, and all the bowing techniques, and then all these sliders for volume and style blend and everything. You're going to be a little overwhelmed, but to be honest, I was a little overwhelmed, but it's not tough at all. Like, any person who knows their way around the synth or anyone who's used the sample engine before will easily get to know this. It's, you know, once you do, it is more than worth it, absolutely more than worth it, and it is truly, truly breathtaking, all the power that you have there. So, to answer the question, it is very easy to use. Just take a few minutes, read through the manual if you have to. If you run into issues, the tech support is amazing. So I witnessed that firsthand if you run into any issues, but it is very easy, very user-friendly to use. So the fact that you only need just one MIDI track per instrument, so, you know, you'll have five total, one for first violins, one for second, one for viola, cello, and double bass, and that's all you need. Nothing irritated me more than opening a session and, you know, for the first violins I'd have, you know, 16, you know, maybe 32 tracks just for that. And it'd be so uninspiring to just look at, and, you know, you're dragging MIDI here just to, you know, to make it sound real, and you're adjusting. It'd be more technical than more inspiration and passionate, you know. But the real-time playability as well is the key selling point, and it goes above every other library. Is you can go from pizzicato to legato like that, and you can go from a sense of vibrato, you know, sustain, just a light sustain, bring it up into a tremolando like that. You know, you don't have to be going between MIDI tracks, you don't have to be doing all these control changes and everything. Is there a lot of control changes that you can do? Absolutely. There's going through the manual, there's a ridiculous amount that you can control. But once you actually just start working with it, you realize you don't need that many CC changes. You don't need a lot. You know, as long as you have control over the volume and style blend being able to go from, you know, a nice sustain all the way up to a nice thick vibrato. Being able to go to sol ponticello to sol tasto, you know, in real time, just in a matter of seconds, is huge. And just a few other little sliders that, you know, that just that you don't need a lot of controls for. You know, I have 16 right here that I think I only use three, and I use a volume controller or a foot pedal, and then, you know, your mod wheel. And, yeah, it's real time playability is surpasses any other library. There's no loading little patches. Oh, you want to make the string player straight play on one string? Okay, you have to load this patch. And if you want to force them to play on fourth, third, and second string, you got to load all these patches. And it becomes so time consuming and so, like I said before, uninspirational that you're sitting there loading patches. And if you don't like the sound, you're like, oh, then you gotta unload them, and it just becomes a huge headache. So it's real time playability goes above and beyond the library itself, and it makes it incredibly powerful. And it is it is why I've now considered my number one go-to library. You can everything from a full 70-piece orchestra right down to just solo strings and huge cinematic sound to as intimate and detailed as possible. And I will say that I've used a lot of reverbs before, but their space engine that they use for their reverb is absolutely fantastic. It is sonically beautiful, and the ambience that you can get from it all the way down to as close as you want to the instruments is bone-chilling is what it really is. So, basically that's a quick little my little few cents on the 70 DVZ strings. Like I said, it's incredibly powerful, incredibly easy to use, all in real time, and make the strings all your own. So, thank you.